The Roadshow Center is located in the Tianfu New Area of Chengdu. The core area of Tianfu New Area has one of Chengdu's largest water surfaces, Xinglong Lake. Since the project is particularly close to the water surface, it becomes a building that stands out in the entire urban area, a building that is easily noticed. So in our design process, we attempted to interpret the site, interpreting the functions we want to incorporate and how to better integrate them with the environment. Actually, when our city managers were thinking about how to build and how to construct this roadshow center, they had many reasonable but sometimes seemingly contradictory demands. For example, they wanted it to be a landmark, but at the same time, they did not want it to stand out too much in the landscape. So we adopted two different facades. For the side facing the lake, we could make it more dynamic. Its form is very simple. The large interior space is connected to the outside through a transparent glass curtain wall. On the exterior, we covered it with scale-like structures, which allows it to have a dazzling and dynamic feel, yet subdued. At the same time, the side facing the park takes on a more humble aspect. It's like a simple lookout or observation tower, a structure that allows everyone to walk up to the top of the building.
I think the difficulty of the Roadshow Center project lies in the need for some noticeable features of a cultural landmark building. But at the same time, we needed to handle the surrounding environment and elevation differences, especially with the choice of a curved surface and how this curved design will be implemented successfully in the final construction stage. This was a major challenge of the project. So we used double curved surfaces, both in the facade design and in the connection with the ground. Both areas adopted double curved forms. In the mid to late stages of construction, such forms caused many challenges in complex constructions. In the mid to late stages, to deal with the double curved form, we used the Archicad Rhino connection and created the double curved surfaces. We also used the same tool for the divisions of the curtain wall and also as a construction guideline. We generated a curved structure in Rhino and then linked it with Archicad to create the model. For example, the GRC stone shaders on the facade were created in Rhino and then linked to Archicad, allowing for further editing within Archicad, instead of being a static imported object. This was helpful for the later development of our design, providing substantial assistance.